Hello dear students, so in the last class we had discussed the operation and control of the UPQC and we had seen the basics and the classification of UPQC and today we shall discuss the control of UPQC. Okay, so before proceeding further I would like to remind you about the topics which we had discussed regarding the UPQC. तो लास्ट टाइम हमने यूपीक्यूसी का इंट्रोडक्शन देखा था ओके एंड क्लासिफिकेशन मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंटली हमने डिस्कस किया था लास्ट टाइम. सो बेस्ड ऑन द टोपोलॉजी जो क्लासिफिकेशन है वो राइट सेंट यूपीक्यूसी और लेफ्ट सेंट यूपीक्यूसी दो पार्ट्स में दो काइंड से इसके देयर टू टाइप्स ऑफ दिस यूपीक्यूसी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ topology. Okay, that is right shunt UPQC and left shunt UPQC. Now on the method of control, on the basis of method of control, there are three types, that is UPQCQ, UPQCP and UPQCS. So this everything we had discussed in the last class, but this is just for reminding it or recalling it. So UPQCQ means a DVR is used for series voltage injection in quadrature with the supply current with almost zero active power injection. Okay, so UPQCQ कौन सा configuration है जिसमें जो DVR हम use करते हैं किस काम के लिए, series voltage injection के लिए, वो in quadrature होता है, means 90 degree apart with the supply current. Okay, and zero active power injection. UPQCP configuration means a DVR is used for series voltage injection in phase with the supply current. तो इस केस में क्या अंतर है UPQCQ और UPQCP में, कि इसमें Q केस में वोल्टेज इंजेक्शन सीरीज वोल्टेज इंजेक्शन होता है और ये जो है सप्लाई करंट के क्वाड्रेचर में होता है, बट यहाँ पर यहाँ भी सीरीज वोल्टेज इंजेक्शन के लिए DVR यूज करते हैं, बट यहाँ पर वो इन फेज होता है, मीन्स DVR इज यूज फॉर सीरीज वोल्टेज इंजेक्शन इन फेज विद द सप्लाई करंट. ओके एंड विद ओनली एन एक्टिव पावर इंजेक्शन, यहाँ पर जीरो एक्टिव पावर इंजेक्शन था, यहाँ पर ओनली एक्टिव पावर इंजेक्शन. एंड UPQCS, ओके तो S का क्या मतलब है, DVR इज यूज फॉर सीरीज वोल्टेज इंजेक्शन एट ऑप्टिमम फेज एंगल विद मिनिमम KVA रेटिंग. ओके सो दीज आर द थ्री क्लासिफिकेशन or the three types of UPQC on the basis of method of control. Now let's proceed further. So today we shall discuss the control criteria of UPQC. So there may be a number of criteria for the control of UPQC similar to the UPFC. Okay, जैसे unified flow, power flow controller में होता है उसी तरह से there are various methods or ways of controlling this UPQC in transmission system. Okay, so which is mainly used to control the active power flow in both the directions with an injection of series voltage with active and reactive powers. Okay, so हम mainly क्या करते हैं, हम active power flow को control करते हैं. The main thing is to control the active power. Okay, in both the directions with an injection of series voltage. How do we control this? By injecting series voltage with the active and reactive powers. So the UPFC is a very versatile power controller used for the control of active and reactive powers in four quadrants alike. Okay, so UPFC is a versatile power controller to control the active and reactive powers in all the four quadrants. So UPQC may be controlled to inject a series voltage between the AC mains and consumer loads through a series compensator. Okay, dynamic voltage restorer DVR is the series compensator at any angle from just 0 degree to 360 degree. Okay, so that's why we call it versatile. Why we call it versatile? Because it facilitates the wide range of operating angle. Okay, we can operate this in between 0 and 360 degree. Okay, so that's why we call it all the four quadrant operation, because we know that the four quadrants 0 to 90, 90 to 180, 180 to 270 and 270 to 360. There are four quadrants, so it covers all the four quadrants. Okay, used to control in all the four quarters. That's why the operating angle is in between 0 to 360. So within that range, the UPQC may be controlled to inject a series voltage between the AC mains and consumer loads. Okay, with the help of DVR. DVR के through क्या कर सकते हैं? UPQC को हम control कर सकते हैं by injecting a series voltage between what? The AC mains and the consumer. So in this way, we can provide the control to UPQC. Now, control of UPQC as UPQC-Q. So this UPQC-Q we have already discussed. While we are discussing, I was just recalling the types of UPQC studied in the last lecture. So in this mode, a DVR is used mainly for reactive power injection for fundamental voltage compensation. So this DVR, that is dynamic voltage restorer, is used, okay, for reactive power injection. So reactive power को inject करने के लिए इस mode में UPQCQ mode में हम DVR का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, okay, for the fundamental voltage compensation. Now in this case, the series voltage is injected in quadrature with the AC mains current that we have already seen when we were discussing this UPQCQ configuration. So इस configuration में क्या होता है? Series voltage inject किया जाता है in quadrature with the AC mains current. Or we can say that current flowing through DVR so that no active power is needed for series voltage injection. So there is no active power in this case. Okay. So series voltage को in quadrature, 90 degree के phase shift के साथ, जो कि AC mains current के साथ होता है, या फिर जो current DVR के through flow follow करता है, that is no active power is needed for series voltage injection in that case. Okay, so this DVR cannot compensate for voltage swell in the UPQCQ mode of operation. So इस mode of operation में जो DVR है वो voltage swell को compensate नहीं कर सकता. Swell क्या चीज होती है? The rise in voltage. Okay, sag is the reduction in voltage. Okay, so this sag, swell, flicker, harmonics, everything we have discussed. Okay, previously, that they are the power quality differences, power quality issues or power quality problems that we frequently come across in the transmission system. Okay, so this DVR cannot compensate for voltage swell in the UPQCQ mode of operation. Okay, voltage swell ko compensate nahi kar sakta. In this case, the D-STATCOM compensates the reactive power of the consumer load and a unity power factor is realized at PCC. So इस केस में क्या होता है? DS.com जो है, that provides the compensation, the reactive power compensation to the consumer load. Okay, and thus maintaining a unity power factor at PCC. That is, PCC is what? Point of common coupling. Okay, so this unity power factor is ensured by the compensation provided by, reactive compensation provided by DS.com. Now, with this phasor diagram, everything will be clear. So you can see this phasor diagram. Okay, this is the VS, source side voltage. VL is the load side. Okay. Now, this IL is lagging this VS or VL with phi angle. Okay, that is the phase angle. And this VL dash is leading this VL, okay, and IS is in phase with this VS, fine, and this is the angle delta. Now the DVR injects a voltage in quadrature with the AC mains current. Okay, this DVR injects a voltage in quadrature with the AC mains current, because we are discussing this UPQCQ configuration. So this DVR injects a voltage in quadrature with the AC mains current, and in this case of voltage sag compensation also. There is a limitation of sag compensation depending upon the voltage rating of the DVR. So the voltage sag can be expressed as this. Okay, so this is the expression which is representing the voltage sag. Okay, x equals to VLC minus root over VLC square minus V square dVR upon VLC. What is x? X is the percentage of voltage sag for compensation. V dVR is the injected voltage by the dVR, and VLC is the load voltage after the compensation. Okay, so with this VDVR, VLC, we can determine the percentage of voltage sag for compensation. Okay, so from this expression we can determine. Now in this case, if the maximum or rated injected voltage is known, then from the above equation we can calculate the maximum level of voltage sag that can be compensated in this mode of operation. Okay, so if this VDVR is known, if this VDVR, that is the injected voltage by the DVR, is known to us, then we can calculate the maximum level of voltage sag that can be compensated. Okay, means the up to what level of voltage sag we can provide the compensation in this UPQCQ mode, that can be calculated if this injected voltage DVR is known. So in this case, now the D STATCOM has to supply some amount of active power to meet the losses of the UPQC. So this D STATCOM will come into picture, and it has to supply some amount of active power to meet the losses of UPQC. So UPQC ke losses ko compensate karne ke liye, okay, kuch amount of active power ki zarurat hogi, and that will be taken care of by this D STATCOM. Okay, now but it does not supply active power to the DVR, so the DVR does not inject any active power. Okay, so since ye koi active power DVR ko supply nahi karta, isliye active power will not inject any DVR will not inject any active power. Okay, so therefore this mode of UPQC is considered the most conservative and provides minimum level of compensation. So ye jo UPQC mode hai, ये जो है ये बहुत कंजर्वेटिव कहलाता है, एंड मिनिमम लेवल ऑफ कॉम्पनसेशन हम अचीव कर पाते हैं इस मोड से. ओके, यू कैन सी नाउ द रेटिंग कैलकुलेशन ऑफ बोथ डीवीआर एंड डी स्टेटकॉम मे बी डन फ्रॉम द फेजर डायग्राम. ओके, सो द इंजेक्टेड वोल्टेज बाय द डीवीआर इज V dVR equals to root over of VLC square minus VS square. Okay, so from here we can see this V dVR is equals to root over of VLC square minus this VS square. Okay, what is VLC? VLC is the load voltage after compensation. Okay, so obviously this voltage is more, this VLC, the load voltage after the compensation. That's why this VDVR equals to root over of VLC square minus VS square. Now the VA rating of the DVR is, volt ampere rating of the DVR can be represented. This can be also written as apparent power, so it is denoted by S. So S DVR equals to VDVR into IS. Okay. Now what is VDVR into IS? This is equal to VS IL cos phi tan delta. Okay, so this relation is to calculate the VA rating of the DVR, and where this IS and IL are the supply and load current. So IS is the supply current and IL is the load current. Okay, and cos phi is the load power factor. Okay, and delta is the angle between the load voltage and the voltage after compensation. Delta is the angle between the load voltage and the voltage after compensation. Here in the phasor diagram it is more clear. This delta is the angle between the load voltage and voltage after compensation. So this is the load voltage and this is the voltage after compensation. So delta is the angle between these two. Okay, that's why I say it as a VDVR. Okay, and IS and IL are the supply and load curves. Okay. Now, for the control of the DSTATCOM part of this UPQC, sensing of PCC voltage, that is point of common coupling voltage, load current, supply current, and DC bus voltage is required to derive the reference supply current for the PWM current controller in SRF theory, synchronous reference frame theory. Okay. So, in order to control this DSTATCOM part of the UPQC, the sensing of PCC voltage, load current, supply current, and DC bus voltage required to derive the reference supply current for the PWM current controller. Okay. So, अगर हमें DSTATCOM के पार्ट को कंट्रोल करना है, UPQC के DSTATCOM पार्ट को कंट्रोल करना है, तो ये जो PCC वोल्टेज है, लोड करंट है, सप्लाई करंट और DC बस वोल्टेज, ये सभी को मॉनिटर करना पड़ेगा. ओके. और इनको इनका यूज करते हुए एट ए टाइम बाय सेंसिंग दीज थिंग्स द बाय मेजरिंग दीज क्वांटिटीज वी हैव टू डिराइव द रेफरेंस सप्लाई करंट. तो इनके हेल्प से रेफरेंस सप्लाई करंट डिराइव किया जाता है और जो कि PWM करंट कंट्रोलर के द्वारा इस्तेमाल करके इसको कंट्रोल प्रोवाइड करते हैं. द सप्लाई करंट्स हैव टू सप्लाई ओनली रिएक्टिव ओनली एक्टिव पावर व्हिच हैज टू पार्ट्स. ओके. वन हैज द लोड एक्टिव पावर एंड अनदर टू मीट द लॉसेस ऑफ द यूपीक्यूसी. ओके. सो सप्लाई करंट हैव टू सप्लाई ओनली एक्टिव पावर बट इट हैज टू पार्ट्स. वन पार्ट इज लोड एक्टिव पावर and another to meet the loss of UPQC. So the active power component of load current is estimated by this SRF, synchronous reference frame transformation of load current, and then filtered for its DC component, which represents the required active power component of load current. Okay. So the active power component of load current kaise estimate kiya jata hai? Synchronous reference frame theory ke dwara. Okay. What kind of transformation takes place here? The transformation, the SRF transformation of load current and then filtered for its DC component. DC component ko usko filter kar liya jata hai, DC offset, which represents the required active power component of the load current. Okay. So for this SRF transformation, the transformation angle is obtained from PLL, that is phase lock loop over positive sequence PCC voltage. The other part of the active power component of supply current is estimated as PI controller over the DC bus UPQC. So, the दूसरा part है active power component का supply current का, उसको हम proportional integral controller PI controller के through estimate करते हैं. Okay, over the DC bus UPQC. And the sum of these active power component of supply current is considered as the amplitude of reference supply current. Okay. So this amplitude of reference supply currents and the transformation angle obtained from PLL over positive sequence PC voltage are used to compute the three-phase instantaneous reference supply current. Okay. So जो reference supply current का amplitude है और जो transformation angle है जो कि PLL से मिला है phase lock loop से, उसको हम यूज करके थ्री फेज इंस्टेंटेनियस रेफरेंस सप्लाई करंट जनरेट करते हैं या डिराइव करते हैं. और जो डिराइव्ड थ्री फेज रेफरेंस सप्लाई करंट है और जो सेंस सप्लाई करंट्स है, उसको यूज करते हैं पीडब्ल्यूएम करंट कंट्रोलर्स में फॉर जनरेटिंग द गेटिंग सिग्नल्स ऑफ दिस आईजीबीटीज एंड ऑफ द डीएसटैटकॉम. तो डीएसटैटकॉम के जो आईजीबीटी स्विचेज हैं, उनको गेट पल्स देने के लिए हम उनका इस्तेमाल करते हैं. सो द पीडब्ल्यू करंट कंट्रोलर्स जनरेट द गेटिंग सिग्नल फॉर दैट. सो द फॉर द कंट्रोल ऑफ दिस डीवीआर, द रेफरेंस इंजेक्टेड वोल्टेज आर कंप्यूटेड फ्रॉम द डिफरेंस ऑफ दिस रेफरेंस लोड वोल्टेज एंड सेंस पीसीसी वोल्टेज. एंड द थ्री फेज रेफरेंस लोड वोल्टेज आर कंप्यूटेड फ्रॉम अ डिजायर्ड रेफरेंस एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ लोड वोल्टेज एंड द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंगल ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम पीएलएल ओवर द सेंस डीवीआर सप्लाई करंट. And then these three-phase reference injected voltages are given to PWM voltage controller for generating the gating signals for IGBTs of the DVR. So in this way, the reference is set and it is given to the PWM controllers to obtain the gating signals for the IGBTs of this DStatcom and the DVR.